guys, Joe Adula Design here, and today we're going to go over the latest product of ours, which is the Mark IV Supra ECU Modular Mount System. This will be a product unboxing as well as vehicle installation. The first thing I would recommend is to go ahead and go on our website, download the PDF instruction manual. This is also a layout with a quick link guide, so you can simply click on your module of choice. It will direct you to the bolt pattern of that module, and you can install all of your units prior to installing this to the vehicle. So let's go ahead and get this product unboxed, and then we can show you how everything goes together prior to going into the car. You will receive some decals on top. Product is well padded. If it is damaged upon arrival, please contact us and we will take care of that. Okay, so you'll have all your miscellaneous hardware taped up here. Velcro on the side, several feet of that. High-tech adhesive. Your main standoffs. And instead of tearing this up, we're going to go ahead and display a unit that's already out of the box. So we'll go ahead and do that now. So for your standoffs, you'll have the lowers in the front, which will be here and here. And the longer standoffs will go up here, here, or here, and these are optional and have corresponding holes on the cover, depending on how you want to lay out your board with your ECUs, PDMs, etc. Some of you may need that room on either left or right side for your Amphenol connector harnesses, can stuff, etc. It's up to you. It's really your prerogative. Okay, so let me go ahead and get these installed, and I will show you how that works, and then we'll get this thing in the car and go from there. Okay guys, so you can see where I've installed the conical washers and bolts on the back side of this. Like I said, you can also utilize this one if you want to. That will give you the wider footprint option. And this is how it should look like, minus your units before going in the vehicle. So we'll have all four of our standoffs on here. Obviously, the plate or top cover will reside here. And before you put this in the car, you can loosen these back up and adjust them accordingly to correspond with the top cover holes. Okay guys, so we went ahead and loaded up this setup with the Haltech Elite setup. As you can see, there's still plenty of room on the board. Even if you wanted to add the PD16, we actually have a designated spot up here, as I talked about earlier. You could still add that. GPS right here, that's pre-designated as well. Once again, please refer to the quick link PDF guide we have that will show you all your pre-determined hole allocations. Let's go ahead and get this thing installed in the car. But first, we need to go ahead and address the pre-installation, which is adding this shim to the upper left HVAC unit, adding this shim to the upper right HVAC unit. So let's go ahead and do that now. Okay guys, this is a bit difficult to do with a camera in your hand under the dash, but I'm going to give it my best shot. So I'm going to assume that you already have your stock skeleton removed from the vehicle that retains the stock ECU and ABS unit. When you pull that out, you're going to have to pull the orange header out that sits right here. You can depress this pin and it'll simply slide off of that galvanized unit on the bottom of the HVAC unit, okay? After that's done, you can pick up the top right bracket and slide it in perpendicular, like so. Once it's in, you can simply just flip it 90 degrees down, align the hole so you can see it through both sides to the firewall, and then you're ready to put a bolt in there. Okay, and your second shim simply slides behind the HVAC unit on the top left side. This assumes the space in between the firewall and this bracket. That way, when we bolt down our new ECU mount, it won't snap this off your HVAC system, which you probably can't replace and don't want to, because then you'll have to remove your dash, which would be terrible. So go ahead and slide that in. Make sure you can see all holes through the firewall. And at that point, you can go ahead and install the base bracket after we get our neoprene washers down, which we'll do now. Okay guys, so you have the two studs that normally hold the skeleton bracket on either side of the bottom of the ECU mount from the factory. We're going to grab the two neoprene washers out of our kit and just slide them over these.
just like so.
Okay guys, when you're installing this, you want to make sure that you slide that conical washer over the base plate as you are setting in the base plate to the floorboard, okay? You don't want to try and put that bolt in after you set it down. It can be a bit of a pain. So always kind of leave it half done when you take it apart and when you put it together. And then you can simply slide it underneath, okay? Okay guys, so here you can see that we've got the base plate in. We've already started our upper bolts on both sides, left them kind of loose. We're now going to apply our washer and lock nut on the bottom plate here. Those take a 10 millimeter socket. Just go ahead and do that to both sides. Okay guys, so you can see that the topper is now installed. This will protect your units from your passengers' feet. Four conical washers and bolts are used to install this. You can see the bottom two are recessed. The top two are above the unit. And after this, we'll go ahead and put the carpet up. Okay guys, go ahead and install your carpet. You can install your side kick panel as well. Just align your pin to the carpet on the floorboard and then use your popper pin to hold it too. That's the only thing that really holds it from the OE anyway. There is a little bit of a high rise here, but it's nothing crazy. It's just what we had to do to fit all the modules that the customers requested. As soon as you put your carpet down, you'll never even know it's there. If you have any questions, please call us. Don't hesitate to email or call at any time if you have any questions, okay? We'll walk you through any problem that you may have or get you any parts that you may need.